In the name of the Father, and Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ says to us the words which he heard now in the Gospel according to St. John chapter 6. Don't labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to everlasting life, which the Son of Man will give you. These words, in fact, not only we accept it for practicing fasting, but this is the command of the Lord Jesus Christ. We have to accept it in all our life. What the Lord means by saying, don't labor for the food which perishes, and at the same time, he said, but for the food which endures to everlasting. The food which perishes, we eat it and it will be consumed. But the food which endures forever cannot be consumed. It changes us from being immortal to be, in fact, like the angels of God, to live forever. I remember once a person was speaking concerning food and said, unfortunately, the majority of the ladies who prepare the food, they mix the food with sin. They are hearing some songs. They are condemning any person. They have calls, and in these calls, they are involved in the earthly things. The righteous ladies, or those who prepare the food, has to put in their mind, when they prepare the food for the family or the guests, the foods must be mixed by prayer, by lifting up their hearts to heaven, by looking to the eternal feast, by sharing the heavenly hosts their table or their feasts. When we prepare the food, the Lord don't labor, because when any food is made, we have to work, or any person work, to prepare it for us. Saint Ephrem the Syrian, in his book, in this, I think many months, I am involved in the book of Ephrem the Syrian, which called On the Paradise. Saint Ephrem said, when the person tasted the paradise life, what happens? He does or she doesn't care about the physical food which perishes, but the person tastes the sweetness of the heavenly food. When in the paradise, he looked to the paradise full of many different trees, spiritual trees, and every tree differs than the other. We will not go to cut the fruits to us, but the trees, it feels their pleasure to come to you and to bring its food to you, and feels that you truly become man of God or become child of God, and they want to serve God himself in you. Then when we eat with our family or our guests or in any place, we ask ourselves, are we in the paradise? Even if I am in a restaurant or in a hotel and they bring the food, do you focus your eyes on the food, or your focus eyes on the atmosphere that you are in paradise and enjoy the fellowship with Christ and to be with the angels and all the heavenly hosts. According to Saint Ephrem, he said, when we eat the food, if we exaggerate in eating, even if we love this food, we will suffer a kind of sickness. And many persons sometimes die because of their gluttony. They eat too much and they lost even their life. In the paradise, when we eat the spiritual food, what happens to us? Not only our souls or our spirits are filled, but also our body will be blessed. And we feel truly we are blessed children of God because our inner man is fulfilled by the work of the Holy Trinity. Sometimes when you speak with a person, he says, oh, my dad or my mom died while I was very young, and I felt lack of emotions or of love, of family, we call warm. The Christian person, the true believer, feels the Holy Trinity is our family. I feel the Father is my own Father, and He wants to pick me and put me in His bosom, not only on the last days, but every time, even while I take my food. The Christian person, according to Saint John Chrysostom and Saint Ambrose, they said nobody, no man in the whole world more happy than the Christian person. When the person awake in the morning, he says, oh, thank you, God. Thank you because your presence granted me to be the happiest person in the world, regardless where I am, in United States, in Egypt, in Australia, regardless the circumstances, I am young, I am old, I am child, regardless our success in this world according to our concept, I am always full of joy, I am always full of happiness, I am in the hands of God the Father who takes care of me. I never forget his providence. He is taking of everything, even the numbering of our hairs are well known to our God the Father. Then God the Father prepared the food to me, that I feel that I am truly not in need of anything. Don't say to any person, I am in need of your emotions, of your love, and so on. I am satisfied by the love of God. Not only I am satisfied by His love, but also through the relationship with God, the human being or the believer becomes a source of joy to everyone, in the family, at his school, at his work, in any place, always with Christians and non-Christians. Everyone look to you and feels you are not from this world. You are full of joy and you grant others to be full of joy. One of the young people in Alexandria, he is working on the ships as an engineer, and lot of the engineers coming from many countries, from Europe, from United States, Canada, Australia, and Russia and so on. Once he told me, when I was all the night working and I left to sleep in the morning, and I went to one of the engineers coming from Russia. He is not Christians, or as they said, he is communist, they don't believe in God. And this person said to him, can I ask you a favor? He said, okay. He said, please, every time when you are going to sleep, before passing to your room in the ship, just come, I want to see you. He said, why? He said, when I see you, all the day I feel I am very happy. I feel as if you are not from this world. He's still alive. Now, I am not speaking concerning somebody died. And many of the atheists, even from Europe or from United States, they were very happy to ask him concerning his belief or his faith. He never started by any words or asking them anything. Just when he dealt with them, they felt that truly he's a man of God. Do we have the same spirit? If I ask our children, what is about your dad or mom? Would they say, the children, I am living in heaven. My dad and my mom, in fact, full of joy. They are the source of joy, not only to me and to my brothers and sisters, but to everyone who comes or met them. Everyone feels that they are like angels of God. Do we have the same spirit? The Lord Jesus Christ also prepares the food which endures to everlasting life. I want to ask St. Peter and St. John and St. James, when they ascend to the top of the mountain of Tabor, did they have food with them? When they came, okay, come with me, we will go to the top of the mountain. Did they say to him, we are in need of food and drink? Did they feel that they were hungry or thirsty? Never. Did they feel that they have even special requests concerning something in this world? Never. What Peter said to the Lord, oh Lord, can you leave us to be here for good? What about your wife and your mother-in-law? And he looked to the Lord Jesus Christ and felt he is satisfied. His heart was satisfied. His spirit was satisfied. Even his body was satisfied. The person, when he has good news, sometimes say, I am satisfied, I am not in need to eat. If you ask him or her, can you eat with us? He said, oh, I am very, very joyful. I am not in need. I feel I am satisfied, even my body. Moses and Elijah fasted for how many days? 40 days and 40 nights. When they went to the mountain of Sinai or Horeb, they didn't prepare food or anything to drink, but they were in fact lifted up to heaven, and they were full of joy. And those two persons alone see the Lord Jesus Christ on the mountain of labor when the Lord was transfigurated. I hope when we come to the liturgy of the Eucharist, which sometimes called Mass, when we come and to share, not to listen, we are not coming to listen. I feel guilty when the people do not share with the deacons singing songs to the Lord. It is the church of the people, not the church of the priest or the deacons, but it is the church of the whole believers, regardless they are laymen or deacons or bishops or pope. All the church has to be full of joy and singing to the Lord Jesus Christ. And he granted his food, the food that endures to the everlasting life. According to Saint Ephrem, he said when we want to eat, we have to buy the food or prepare the food, and it took too much time. When we are in the pledge of the paradise or the pledge of the heaven, the food, or the spiritual food, in fact, costs us nothing. On the opposite, the angels prepare the food and prepare and they offer it joyfully that we share them their heavenly food. I hope truly in our earth, not only in the time of the period of the Great Lent or fasting, but every day we feel that we are in heaven. We are not looking, oh, I will change the food from meat and the mink and so on to take vegetables. That's good, like Daniel. But in fact, I change my situation from being here at home in Washington to be in heaven itself. When a person asks you where you are born, don't say I am born in Egypt or United States. I am born in the Lord Jesus Christ. I am a child of God. My home is heaven. My friends are the heavenly hosts, angels, archangels, principalities, cherubim and seraphim and so on. We hope truly to make or to reevaluate our life. Are we true believers? Are we living in heaven? Are we involved in the glory which has been prepared for every one of us? Do we feel we are the happiest persons in this world? May the Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit and the Father grant all of us to have this experience. And in them, glory be to God. Amen.